बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे इन दिस फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ वीक 11 फॉर द कोर्स अप्लाइड मैथमेटिक्स 1, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंटीग्रेशन और एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स।
डेरिवेटिव्स, इंटीग्रेशन और एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट द डिफिनेशन ऑफ integration or anti derivatives. Suppose we have a function, like you see over here, the capital F function f of x be a differentiable function of x, such that derivative of this f function with respect to x is equal to f of x, where f is the small function, and this is the obtained result of the derivative of this function f. Then this capital F function is called the integral of the function f. Symbolically, it is written as, this is actually the integration sign, integration of function f with respect to x, which is equal to f of x. F of x, the function to be integrated, is called the integrand. And this capital F function is also called the antiderivative or primitive function of small f function. As the differential coefficient of a constant is zero, we have derivative of this f function with respect to x is equal to f of x. And this implies that derivative of this f function plus c with respect to x is equal to f of x. Therefore, the integration of f function with respect to x is equal to this capital F function plus c. The constant c is called the constant of integration and can take any real value. There are two types of integrations. Dear students, note that there are two types of integration. One is the infinite integral and other is the definite integral. So dear students, note that the integration is actually called antiderivative. The process for finding antiderivative of a function is called integration. The geometrical interpretations of the derivative, I have already told you in the previous lecture that the geometrical interpretation of the derivative is actually slope of a function. But the geometrical interpretations of the integration is actually the area of a function. So there are two types of integrations, indefinite integral and definite integral. Indefinite integral is an integral which is not having any upper and lower limit, and known as indefinite integral. And similarly, the definite integral, an integral which is having in any upper and lower limit, is known as indefinite integral. Like you see over here, this integral has no upper and lower limit, so this is the indefinite integral and no specific value. So dear students, know this is the area of the given function. This is the curve of the given function and this is the area under the curve. So you see over here, this area from some limit to other limit. So the integration of the function from the limit A to limit B. So this is actually called the definite integral from A to B. And this integration limit value has no specific value. Now the integral formula. The formula of integral or integration, which are commonly used in the higher level mathematics calculation, using these formulas, we can easily solve any problem related to integration. Like you see over here some formulas of integration, integrals and differentiable formula. Since integration and derivative are anti operators to each other, so dear student, that's why one-to-one formula is present here in this slides. You will understand easily to see the derivative and then take the integration. Dear students, in the previous video lecture, we have already learned that derivative of x power n plus n divided by n plus n plus c, by using the power rule, the derivative of this constant will be zero. And the derivative of this function multiplied the power with the coefficient, so n plus 1 cancel, and subtract 1 from the power, we obtain x power n. Now, if we take the integration of x power n, this will be the result. So this is actually called the antiderivative. we take the integration of x power n with respect to x. So 8 the power 8 1 with the power and 8 1 with the power in the denominator. So you see over here, this is the fundamental definition, this is the fundamental process for the integration, that 8 1 with the power and divide by power plus 1. So in the derivative, dear students, we subtract 1 from the power, but in the integration we subtract 1, we add 1 with the power. In the derivative we subtract 1 from the power, and in the integration we add 1 with the power. So this point is very similar to each other. So in the derivative we multiplied the power with the coefficient and subtract 1 from the power, and similarly in the integration we add 1 with the power and divide by power plus 1. So this is the integration, and plus c, where this c is the constant of integration. In case of indefinite integration we use this constant of integration. But dear students, here is a very important question is to be arise, that why we put this constant c for the integration. Actually I have already told you that integration show area of a function, area of the curve of a function, area under the curve of a function. So x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1, this is actually the area, but x is a variable, so that's why we put plus constant, that someone understand that this term also is a constant term, because we can add the constant with the constant, we cannot add the constant with the variable. So don't confuse that x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 is a variable. No, this is also is a constant term, because it's the area. Area will be a constant term. So that's why we put plus c, plus constant of integration, that this term is also a constant term. For the representation of this term, to indicate this term is a constant, that's why we put this plus constant term. But in case of definite integration, we put the limit for this variable, so the result will be definitely a constant term. So in that case, we don't need to write plus constant of integration. So in the definite integration, we obtain directly this constant term. But in case of indefinite integration, this result actually appear like as a variable, but this is not a variable. That's why we put plus c to indicate that this term is also a constant term, because we add a constant term only with a constant term. Now another formula, the derivative of x plus c is equal to 1 with respect to x. Similarly, now the derivative of 1 will be x plus c. So dear student, note that the derivative of x is 1 and the integration of 1 will be x. Similarly, the derivative of log x plus c is equal to 1 over x. And now the integration of 1 over x will be log x plus c. And the derivative of minus cos x divided by k, minus cos kx divided by k plus c is equal to, since the derivative of cos is minus sine, so minus minus plus, and further derivative of the argument which is equal to k, so k and k cancel, so we obtain derivative of this expression is equal to sine kx. And now the integration of sine kx will be equal to minus cos kx divided by k. So dear students, in case of trigonometric function, note that in case of derivative we take further derivative of the angle in the product form. So in the product form we obtain here, for the further derivative we obtain into k. So that into k, that multiplied k, we put that k in the form of division in case of integration. So integration of sine kx with respect to x will be equal to minus cos kx divided by k plus c. Now the derivative of sine kx divided by k plus c is equal to cos kx. So the integration of cos kx will be equal to sine kx divided by k plus c. And similarly, the derivative of tangent kx divided by k plus c is equal to secant square kx. And the integration of secant square kx will be equal to tangent kx divided by kx. And the derivative of minus cotangent kx divided by k plus c is equal to secant square kx. So the integration of cosecant square kx is equal to minus minus cotangent kx divided by k plus c, and the derivative of secant x divided by k plus c is equal to secant kx into tangent kx. So the integration of secant kx tangent kx will be equal to secant kx divided by k plus c. Similarly, the derivative of minus cosecant kx divided by k plus c is equal to cosecant kx into cotangent kx, and the integration of cosecant kx cotangent kx is equal to minus cosecant kx divided by k plus c. And the derivative of minus log of cos x plus c is equal to tangent x. Similarly, the integration of tangent x is equal to minus log of cos x plus c. The derivative of log of sine x plus c is equal to cotangent x. So the derivative of the integration of cotangent x will be equal to log of sine x plus c. The derivative of e power x divided by a plus c is equal to e power ax. Similarly, the derivative of e power ax with respect to the integration of e power ax with respect to x is equal to e power ax divided by a plus c. Similarly, the derivative of a power x divided by log a plus c is equal to a power x. This is actually the exponential function, general exponential function, and e power ax is the natural exponential function. So the integration of this a power x with respect to x will be equal to a power x divided by log a plus c. Similarly, the derivative of sine inverse x plus c is equal to 1 over under root 1 minus x square, and the integration of 1 over 1 minus x square under root 1 minus x square with respect to x is equal to sine inverse of x plus c. Similarly, the derivative of tan inverse of x plus c is equal to 1 over 1 plus x square. So the integration of 1 over 1 plus x square with respect to x is equal to tan inverse of x plus c. So dear students, you see over here some formula for the integrations. Actually, integration is the anti-process of differentiation. So when the derivative of x with respect to x is 1, so the integration of 1 will be x. So this is a very simple example. Now, a problem to evaluate the integral of x square minus 2x plus 5 with respect to x. So take the integration of x square with respect to x, the integration of 2x with respect to x, and the integration of 5 with respect to x. So we can write the integration of x square with respect to x and put this constant out of integral sign. So 2 into integration of x with respect to x, and we can write 5 into integration of 1 with respect to x. And I have already told you that the integration of 1 is x. So by using the power rule, by using the definition of integration, add 1 with the power, divide by power plus 1. So similarly for this term, the derivative integration of x will be adding 1 with the power, divide by 1 plus power, divide by power plus 1. And the integration of 1 is x. So x cubed divided by 3, excuse me sir, stop Mugga. तो ही शांति रहो यार. सुना टाइम आया सर. अच्छा ना कुछ मैं घंटा पा दे रहा. देखते हैं मरे उच्च शिया. चलता मरे उच्च शी. ना 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 बस खेले. चलता नोट खेल रहा नहीं शुरू से कम स्टाप का. हाँ दा भी अभी एडिट की क्या ना.
तो खेल को यू नेचुरल.
हाँ नेचुरल. हम्म. Let me see this. Okay. So integration of x square with respect to x is equal to x cube divided by 3, and in this term we obtain 2x square divided by 2 plus 5x plus c. This c is the constant of integration. Now 2 and 2 cancel, we obtain x cube by 3 minus x square plus 5x plus c. Now to evaluate the integral, x power 4 plus 3x cube minus 7 with respect to x. Like in this process, like in this example, first of all apply the integration for each term. So integration of x power 4 with respect to x, integration of 3x cube with respect to x, and integration of 7 with respect to x. So we obtain by using the definition 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1, and similarly for this term 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1, and write 7 out of integration. So we can write 7 into integration of 1, and the integration of 1 with respect to x is x. So we can write x power 4 plus 1 divided by 4 plus 1 plus 3 into x power 3 plus 1 divided by 3 plus 1 minus 7x plus constant of integration. Now x power 5 divided by 5 plus 3 by 4 x power 4 minus 7x plus c. Now another problem, to evaluate the integral 3 by 2 under root x with respect to x, and to evaluate the integral 1 over 2 under root x with respect to x, and to evaluate the integral under root x plus 1 under root x with respect to x. So for the part A, we write 3 by 2 into integration of 1 over 2 with respect to x. So by using the fundamental definition of integration, 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1, like you see over here, 3 by 2 into x power 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by 1 over 2 plus 1 plus constant of integration. And this implies that 3 by 2 into x power 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. Now this 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 cancel, we obtain x power 3 by 2 plus c. And we can also write 3 by 2 multiplied 2 by 3 multiplied x power 3 by 2 plus c. So this implies that x power 3 by 2 plus c. Now for the second part, integration of 1 over 2 under root x with respect to x. So first of all, shift the denominator to the numerator. So in the numerator we obtain 1 over 2 into integration of x power minus 1 over 2. 1 over under root x can be written as x power minus 1 over 2. So now the power is minus 1 over 2. So by using the definition, we obtain 1 over 2 multiplied 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1. So x power minus 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 over 2 plus 1 plus constant of integration. And now we can write 1 over 2 multiplied taking the LCM of minus 1 over 2 plus 1. The LCM of minus 1 over 2 plus 1 is very easy. Multiply this 2 with this 1. So we obtain minus 1 plus 2 whole divided by 2. So minus 1 plus 2 mean 1 over 1. So 1 over 2, x power 1 over 2 divided by 1 over 2 plus constant of integration. Now this 1 over 2 and 1 over 2 cancel. And we can also write 1 over 2 multiplied 2 plus under root x plus c. So 2 and 2 cancel, we obtain under root x plus c. Now another part C, the integration of under root x plus 1 over under root x with respect to x. So first of all, take the integration of the first term plus integration of the second term. So the power of the first term is actually 1 over 2, and the power of the second term we can write 1 over under root x is equal to x power minus 1 over 2 like in the previous example. So for the integration, integration of x power 1 over 2 with respect to x, using this formula, 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1. So x power 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by 1 over 2 plus 1 plus, for this term, x power minus 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 over 2 plus 1 and plus constant of integration. So after taking LCM, 2 1 the 2, 1 plus 2 3, so x power 3 by 2. Similarly, in the denominator we obtain 3 by 2, and for this term 2 1 the 2, minus 1 plus 2 equal to 1, so 1 divided by 2, x power 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 2 plus c. Now this term can be written as 2 by 3 into x power 3 by 2 plus 2 into x power 1 over 2 plus c. So this is the result. Now to evaluate the integration of the trigonometric function, like you see over here, integration of minus pi into sine pi x with respect to x, and the integration of 3 into sine x with respect to x, and the integration of sine pi x minus 3 sine 3x with respect to x. So for the first part, integration of minus sine into sine pi x with respect to x, this is the formula. We have already discussed this formula in the previous slide, that the integration of sine kx with respect to x is equal to minus cos kx divided by k. So dear students, note that in case of the derivative, we take the further derivative of the angle and multiply the further derivative result with the previous first derivative. In case of derivative, we take the derivative of the angle, we take the further derivative of the angle, and we write the result with the product form. Similarly, we write that result in integration and in the divide form. Like you see over here, the further derivative of kx with respect to x will be equal to k. So in case of our derivative, we put this k in the form of product. But in case of integration, we put this k result in the division form in case of integration. So by using this formula, integration of sine kx with respect to x is equal to minus cos kx divided by k plus c. So for this function, minus pi is a constant, so this minus pi, right, minus pi is it is, and in the integration of sine pi x is equal to minus cos pi x. And since the further derivative of the argument, the further derivative of the angle is pi, so in case of derivative, we put this pi in the form of the product. But in case of integration, we put this pi in the form of division. So we obtain minus pi into minus cos pi x divided by pi. Now this pi and pi cancel, and minus minus plus, we obtain cos pi x plus c. Now another problem, to take the integration of 3 sine x with respect to x. So write 3 as it is, because 3 is a constant, and the integration of sine x with respect to x implies that the integration of sine is a minus cos, because the derivative of cos is the derivative of cos x is minus sine x. Similarly, the integration of sine x will be equal to minus cos x, and plus c is the constant of integration. So we obtain minus 3 cos x plus c. Now another problem, integration of sine pi x minus 3 sine 3x with respect to x. So taking the integration of each term, integration of sine pi x plus integration of minus 3 sine 3x with respect to x is according to the previous formula, that the integration of sine pi x will be equal to minus cos pi x and divide by this pi. Similarly, the integration of 3 sine x will be equal to minus cos 3x divided by this constant 3 and plus constant of integration. Now minus cos pi x divided by 3, this 3 and 3 cancel, minus minus plus, plus cos 3x plus c. Now another very simple problem, integration of 2x cube minus 5x plus 7 with respect to x. I have already told you in the previous slide that add 1 with the power and divide power plus 1, we obtain the integration of x cube. Similarly, the integration of 5 into x, the integration of x will be x square divided by 2, and the integration of 7 will be write as 7 into integration of 1 with respect to x. So the integration of 1 is x. Now 2 by 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So 2 by 4 into x power 4 by 4, 2 by 4 into x power 4 minus 5 into x square by 2 plus 7x plus c. So 2 to the 4, x power 4 divided by 2 minus 5 by 2 x square plus 7x plus c. Now to integrate the problem, t into under root t plus under root t divided by t square with respect to t. So dear students, in case of derivative, we use the product rule and quotient rule. Now how we can evaluate this integral, because these two functions are in the quotient form. Sometime we can divide these, we can divide two functions. So after division, then we take the integration. But if we cannot divide two functions, then how we can take the integrations? This is the main question. For this problem, when we cannot divide two functions, we will use some formula of integration. In the coming video lecture, I will tell you about that formula, that when two functions are in the divide form and we cannot divide these two functions, then how we can take the integration. But now in this problem, we can easily divide the upper function by this lower function. So we can divide t into under root t plus under root t by t square. We can divide the numerator by the denominator. For the division, we can write t power minus 2 into 3 power t power 3 by 2 plus t power 1 over 2. Now this is actually now the product form. So the base are same, so take only one base and add the power. So t power 3 by 2 minus 2, and similarly t power minus 2 and t power 1 over 2, t power minus 2 plus 1 over 2. Now 2 to the 4, so 3 minus 4 minus 1 over 2, t power minus 1 over 2 plus 2 to the 4, minus 4 plus 1 mean minus 3 by 2. Now this is very simple. Now there is no product, there is no quotient, so we can take easily the integration by using the definition, by using the formula, that 8 1 with the power divided by power plus 1, like you see over here, t power minus 1 over 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 over 2 plus 1. And similarly for the second term, t power minus 3 by 2 plus 1 divided by minus 3 by 2 plus 1 plus constant of integration. And after simplifications, we obtain, taking the LCM, 2 1 the 2 minus 1 plus 2 plus 1. So t power 1 over 2 divided by 1 over 2 plus 2 1 the 2 minus 3 plus 2 mean minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2, t power minus 1 by 2 divided by minus 1 by 2 plus c. And this implies that 2 under root t minus 2 divided by under root t, t power 1 over minus 1 over 2. Now can write 2 divided by t power 1 over 2 plus c. And this implies that 2 under root t minus 2 divided by under root t plus c. Now to evaluate this integral, 4 plus under root t divided by t cube with respect to t. Now here these 4 plus under root t is divided by t cube. So how we can take the integration in case of quotient? But in this problem, I have already told you that we cannot divide the 4 plus t under root t divided by t cube. Like in this problem, there are two functions, one function is divided by other functions. So we cannot divide these two functions. Then we will use some formula for the integration. But in this problem, we can easily divide 4 plus under root t divided by t cube. So for the division, we can write an integration of t power minus 3 into 4 plus t power 1 over 2 with respect to t. So we can write integration of 4 into t power minus 3 plus t and t power minus 3 into t power 1 over 2. We can write t power 1 over 2 minus 3. So after simplifications, we obtain integration of 4 into t power minus 3 with respect to 3 with respect to t plus integration of t power minus 5 by 2 with respect to t. So by using the definition adding 1 with the power divide by power plus 1. So 4 into t power minus 3 plus 1 divide by minus 3 plus 1. And similarly, t power minus 5 by 2 plus 1 divide by minus 5 by 2 plus 1 plus constant of integration. Now 4 into t power minus 2 divided by minus 2 plus 2 1 the 2. For the LCM of minus 5 by 2 plus 1, multiplied this 2 with this number. So 5 minus 5 plus 2 mean minus 3. So we can write minus 3 by 2, like you see over here. In the denominator, we also write minus 3 by 2 plus constant of integration. Now 2 to the 4. So minus 2 power t power minus 2 plus minus 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 2 by 3 and 2 t power minus 3 by 2 plus c. And we can write minus 2 divided by t square minus 2 divided by 3 into t power 3 by 2 plus c. So, dear students, another trigonometric problem to evaluate the integration of 2 cos 2x minus 3 cos 3x. Dear students, in case of trigonometric functions, the integration of trigonometric function is same as like derivative, but we use here the antiderivative. Like the derivative of cos, the derivative of cos is minus sin x, and similarly the derivative of the integration of sin will be minus cos x. But one point is very important. Note that if some constant number is multiplied with the angle is a multiple of some constant, then take the integration by using the formula of trigonometric functions and divide the result with that constant. Divide the result by that constant. Similarly, in case of integration, we multiplied the result with that constant. But in case of integration, divide the result by that constant, which is the multiple of theta. So, for the integration of 2 cos 2x, we write this formula. We use this formula. Integration of cos kx with respect to x will be equal to sin kx divided by k. And similarly, integration of sin kx with respect to x is equal to minus cos ax divided by k. So, the integration of cos 2x by using this formula, sin 2x divided by 2. And similarly, the integration of sin 3x by using this formula, minus cos 3x divided by 3. Now 2 and 2 cancel, 3 and 3 cancel, so we obtain sin 2x plus cos 3x plus c. Now to evaluate the integral 1 plus cos 4x divided by 2 with respect to x. So dear students, we can write 1 over 2 as it is into integration of 1 plus cos 4x in with respect to x. So the integration of 1 with respect to x and the integration of cos 4x with respect to x. So again, using this formula, integration of cos kx is equal to sin kx divided by k. So 1 over 2 is it is, and the integration of 1 is x. Similarly, 1 over 2 is it is, and the integration of cos x is equal to sin 4x divided by 4 plus c. So 2 to the 4, 2 for the 8, and x by 2 is it is x by 2 plus sin 4x divided by 8 plus c. Similarly, like in this problem, we have another problem, integration of 1 minus cos t divided 1 minus cos 6t divided by 2 with respect to t. So take 1 over 2 common, so we can write 1 over 2 integration of 1 minus cos 6t divided by 1 minus cos 6t with respect to t. So take the integration of 1 and the integration of cos 6t by using this formula, integration of cos kt with respect to t, which is equal to sin kt divided by k. So the integration of 1 with respect to t is t, and in the integration of sin 6t, sin 6 in t, the integration of cos 6t, the integration of cos 6t by using this formula will be equal to sin 6t divided by 6 plus c. So we can write 2 6 the 12, so t divided by 2 minus 1 over 12 sin 6 t plus c. Now, another problem of trigonometric functions, integration of cosecant x divided by cosecant x minus sine x with respect to x. So, dear students, note that for the integration of cosecant x divided by cosecant x minus sine x with respect to x, we can write cosecant x is actually 1 over sine x. So, 1 over sine x divided by 1 over sine x minus sine x with respect to x. So, this implies that 1 over 1 divided by sine divided by 1 minus sine square into sine x. Actually, in the denominator, take the LCM. So, 1 over sine x is it is, and the LCM, by taking the LCM of the denominator, we obtain 1 minus sine multiplied with sine, 1 minus sine square divided by sine. So, now we can write integration of 1 over sine x multiplied. We can write this term as sine x divided by 1 minus sine square x. So sine x and sine x cancel. Now we obtain 1 over 1 minus sine square x. And by trigonometric identity formula, we know that sine square x plus cos square is x is equal to 1. So 1 minus sine square x will be equal to cos square. So 1 over cos square is actually secant square x. And we know that the integration of secant square x is equal to tangent x, because the derivative of tangent x with respect to x is a secant square x. Dear students, note that why we simplify this expression in the given integral, because we do not know that cosecant x is the derivative of which function. Cosecant x is the derivative of which function, but we know that secant square x is the derivative of tangent x. The derivative of tangent is secant square. So integration of secant square will be tangent x. So this is the main point, that for the integration of any function, first of all, find this point, that this function is the derivative of which function. So that will be the result of integration. So secant square is actually the derivative of tangent x. That's why integration of secant square x is equal to